Hello everyone, and welcome to a very long overdue next video in our series about OpenCPN. Last time I said we'd be talking about plugins, but there is another topic that I think we need to cover first. Today, we're going to go over the easiest way to get AIS and NMEA data into OpenCPN. My name is David from Out Chasing Stars, and I'd like to invite you to sit back, relax, and let's talk boats. In our OpenCPN videos so far, we've talked through the basics about how to use the software, but having AIS and NMEA data in OpenCPN can transform it into a full-fledged chart plotter. Now, I am a big believer in backups upon backups upon backups, and OpenCPN is definitely one that we've relied on during the entirety of our sailing adventures. To start off, let's define some terms. Hopefully, everyone watching this video is familiar with AIS, which stands for Automatic Identification System, and helps identify other vessels in your area and avoid collisions. It was number 2 on my list of best upgrades for a blue water boat, and I think it is vital for anyone setting out to sea. But NMEA, which stands for National Marine Electronics Association, is probably less well known. It's a protocol that has been designed to exchange data between marine electronic devices. Essentially, it's a way to let different equipment talk to each other on boats. There is a lot of type of data it transmits, including your GPS position, your heading, speed, depth, and wind information. Now, you may commonly hear NMEA 2000 and NMEA 0183. Bit of a tongue twister. 2000 is the more modern protocol used by most marine electronics that you can buy today. But to make things even more confusing, some manufacturers had developed their own proprietary networks based on NMEA standards. For example, on Starry Horizons, our Raymarine NMEA 2000 network is called CTOC-NG. So why am I telling you all of this? Well, there's two reasons. First, OpenCPN is not capable of handling NMEA 2000 data. It needs to be converted into 0183 data first. So it is important to understand the distinction between the two. And second, we're getting into some of the more technical aspects of OpenCPN. So I want to make sure we're all speaking the same language. Now that we've got all that technical jargon defined, for the first time ever in one of our videos, I'm going to take a moment for a word from our sponsor, me. If you own a boat, you know just how much maintenance it takes to keep her on the water. Figuring out what you're supposed to be doing and how often you're supposed to be maintaining it is something that I really struggled with when we first got Starry Horizons. That's why my brother Thomas and I have teamed up to develop Maintenance Right on Schedule. This is a built from the ground up solution to help you identify and track all the maintenance tasks for your boat. You can search through our marine equipment database or even build your own maintenance schedule. We'll customize the schedule for your whole boat and alert you when it's time to get to work. This is something we have put our heart and soul into, and I am so happy to share it with you guys first. You can go to maintenanceros.com to start a free 14-day trial, no credit card needed. And as an additional thank you to all of our viewers, I'm going to offer you a limited time discount. When you sign up, use the code OUTCHASINGSTARS to get 20% off for 6 months if you decide to continue after your trial. We all know maintenance is such a critical part of boat ownership. Let us make that part easier so you can spend more time enjoying the water. Thank you for watching, well, me. And I just have to say again, I am so excited to finally be able to share MaintenanceROS with you. If you own a boat, I would love for you to give it a try and send me some feedback about your experience. We really want to make this as useful for boaters as possible. Okay, let's move on. There are now several ways to get AIS and NMEA data into OpenCPN, but I believe the easiest and most powerful way is over Wi-Fi. For example, today, I'm going to show you how we use our Vesper Marine AIS to do just that. Later on, I'll talk about some of the other alternatives available that can do the same thing. The first step is going to be connecting your computer to the Wi-Fi device. I do this quite often with our Vesper AIS, so it's one of my saved networks. Come up to my network connections, and I'm already connected. So, since I'm already connected to the network, I'm going to come back into OpenCPN, and I'm going to open the Options menu and come over to the Connections tab. From there, we're going to want to come down and select Add Connection. Now we have to configure our connection, but fortunately for me, Vesper has a super helpful support page set up to instruct us on how to do just that. Make sure we have got the network connection selected. We need to select the TCP protocol. The address is going to be 192.168.151, and the data port is going to be 39150. I can add a user comment in here and just note that this is going to be my Vesper, so I can remind myself in the future. But I do want to note that these settings will likely be different if you're using a device that's not a Vesper Marine AIS. You'll need to look up in your owner's manual for the proper settings, or maybe even reach out to their company support, or there is pretty good OpenCPN forum on Cruiser's forum. Now for the rest of the options down at the bottom, I'm going to leave as is. Now let's go ahead and hit Apply. And you should see that the connection has been created, and by default, it should already be enabled. We can hit OK to come out of the Options menu and come back into the chart view, and we want to keep an eye on the GPS connection status in the upper right-hand corner. It's turned green, and that means the Vesper AIS is properly transmitting the NMEA data, and it's being read by OpenCPN. If you remember in one of our last videos, I used a GPS puck to get GPS data, but the nice thing about using this Wi-Fi connection is that GPS is included in all the other NMEA data being sent. You'll notice we've got Starry Horizons in red, and we're down here at Hog Key in the Bahamas. It takes a little while, but depending on just how remote you are, you should also start seeing some additional triangles pop up. These are going to be the AIS targets we can now play with. But before I show you all that fun stuff, let's come back into the Options menu. And this time we're going to come over to the Ships tab and then into our AIS Targets options. Now OpenCPN has a lot of configurable options, and it's worth playing around a bit just to get things set up right for you. Now you can adjust your closest point of approach parameters to fit your own situation. Let's say maybe you're in a busy port. You may only want to get warnings if a vessel is coming super close to you. That might be more appropriate. Now if you're out in the open ocean and you just want to be warned if anyone is coming around, a greater range may be worth it, so you can keep an eye out for any unexpected maneuvers. Now further on down, we come to the rollover options. This is where you can customize whatever appears on the screen when you mouse over an AIS target. I like having the Enable Route AIS Info block and then the CPA and TCPA. Those are two pretty good selections. So, now let's get back to the chart. We've got some targets that are in green. Now these are going to be the identified vessels that present no danger. And as I'm rolling over them, you can start to see vessel name, and because we selected that CPA, we actually have a CPA and time, which is really nice and fast to see. Now, we are, like I said, in a pretty remote place, so we don't have a whole lot of targets around us. But if there was a yellow target, that means that OpenCPN can't identify the vessel name, but the boat doesn't currently present any danger. Now, depending on how long of an interval the other boat's AIS is set up to transmit at, it can take a little while before a name comes through, so the target may stay yellow for a bit. Now, since we are anchored at the moment and it is night, there isn't anybody on the move, so we're not seeing any red targets, which would be a vessel that presents a potential danger. Now, if you see those, you would definitely want to keep an eye on them. Now, if we want to get a bit more information about the AIS target, we can right-click on one, come down to Target Query. That's going to bring up all the other information available about that vessel. Now, I particularly enjoy watching this report age. I think it's just kind of fun to see how often other boats transmit their AIS data. And if it's been a long time since you've received a report, well, maybe it's worth keeping a closer visual on that boat since they could have changed course and it may not be reflected in their AIS target. Now, again, down here at the bottom, we've got a couple options that I personally have used quite a bit. If you know another boat's in a good spot, say a really good anchorage, you can drop a waypoint and then navigate directly to it. I have also used this record track feature if we're trying to navigate somewhere that's, say, poorly marked, but a local vessel knows the proper way in through the reefs, you can record their track and then follow them in. So that can be incredibly helpful. Now, I'm not sure if we're going to have any boats that are moving tonight. We do have one. So if I right-click on them, I've got another option, the Show Target CPA. I think this is a really cool visual representation of where the two boats are actually going to cross. In fact, I think it's a better visual display than we get in our Raymarine chart plotter. In crowded situations, I've actually come down to watch the CPAs on OpenCPN because I think it's a quicker and easier way to figure out which target is actually a threat. We've touched quite a lot on how to navigate and use AIS, but what about all that NMEA data? This is where plugins come in and why we needed to do this video first. Now, my next video will do a deeper dive into all the fun things we can do with plugins, but for now, I'll give you a quick preview to whet your appetite. One of the plugins included with OpenCPN is called the Dashboard, and over here in the menu, we've got a nice icon for the Dashboard. Just like you'd think, you can customize it to include all the things that NMEA data is being transmitted to you. Now here's an example with one that I've set up. It's not going to be super interesting at the moment because we're not sailing, but I do like to be able to see the local sunrise and sunset based on our position. We have the compass information, I can see all the GPS connection status, see our speed over ground, swinging a little bit with the wind tonight, even apparent and true wind angle, we've got course over ground, we've got the depth, which you know you're in the Bahamas because that's super shallow, and then there's even water temperature. I'll have to be a little patient because I'm going to go over how to customize the dashboard and add other plugins next time. To wrap things up, I do also want to touch on some of your other options for getting AIS and NMEA data into OpenCPN if you don't have a Vesper Marine AIS. There are several other Wi-Fi gateway devices that you can hook into your NMEA system and allow you to connect into the network, just like we've done today. Yacht Devices makes a fairly easy plug-and-play gateway that other friends have told me works quite well. It also offers the ability to send messages back to Marine Electronics, so you could create a route in OpenCPN and send it up to your chart plotter at the helm if you'd like. OceanNav is another company that makes NMEA to Wi-Fi converters, but it looks a bit less plug-and-play and would require some additional wiring to be done. Their top-of-the-line model is a bit more expensive, but it does have the ability to support an optional remote control that would integrate with Raymarine, BNG, and Simrad autopilots. I should also note that if you have a recent BNG chart plotter with Wi-Fi, it is possible to configure it as a Wi-Fi hotspot and send NMEA 0183 data, which can be used by OpenCPN. I have tried to connect OpenCPN to our Raymarine Wi-Fi network, but it doesn't seem to work. So I guess it's just a BNG feature at this point. I am going to leave a link in the description below to the OpenCPN wiki on supplemental hardware. That's going to have many more options for you, including some that can be hardwired into the system if you have the technical know-how. I think that's going to wrap things up for now. I really hope you guys have enjoyed this return to OpenCPN and feel a bit more comfortable with how to get the AIS and NMEA data into the program. We're going to keep building from here towards some of the more advanced topics, which will include how to make your own charts. Thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you another day in another bay. Bye, y'all.